Today we are going to learn about the movement and visibility in the iFIX SCADA. So go to database manager. You have to create a new tag for the analog input. So my tag name will be analog input AI, selecting the tag name, and the name will be MV, which represents the movement and visibility, and the IO address will be 0. Go to advanced, go to enable the output. That's it. My tag name is created. For fetching the current value, right click here and refresh. Now the current value is 0.0 and save it and close the database manager. So after, I'm going to draw a polyline. Before that, I have to enable the grid, toggle the grid. So the grid is here, so I can easily be drawing for the polyline. So here, from the beginning, from here you can draw my polyline like this. I've drawn my polyline like this, and I'm going to untoggle the grid. Okay, now here is my polyline, and I have to insert an object. This is my object that have to be moved towards right. This is the movement will be towards here, the horizontal to right, and the combined horizontal and vertical to up, and the horizontal to left, and the combined horizontal and vertical towards the right, left, or the down. This is my motion. Have to duplicate these things 4 times. Duplicate. Yes, and I have to place these things here. Very precisely, have to place these things. Otherwise, the movement should be in a bad way. So, I have placed all these objects here. This is my movement, and first I am going to configure my movement. Double click for movement position. Position here, and I have to give the tag. Fix MV F. Okay, I have configured my tag, and position is horizontal. Only we are configuring the horizontal position for the first one. I am giving the slider value, so my lowest input values will be 0 and highest will be at 25. That's it, and we are going, the position type is absolute, and I'm going to get the start value from here. They have to give the end value. For getting the end value, I'm going to the next one position. I'm going to assign my tag name F. Okay, and the input value should be 25, that is starting from 25 and ending at 50. And absolute, and the start value 430.875. that is my end value of my first block, 430.875. That is my end value of my first block. That's it. So okay, and okay, that's it. And go to the second one. You can see the position is here. We need the combined horizontal and vertical motion for the second block. So horizontal, I checked the horizontal and also the vertical from 25 to 50 is right range. The start value, I'm getting the start value from here, and I should have to get the end value of the horizontal and vertical from the next block. So okay, configuring my next block. Position, fix, MV, F, okay, and I'm getting my horizontal and vertical start values, absolute start, I'm getting values 490.875 and 42.357500. So I'm getting, copying this value, Control C, and okay. Movement, the end value should be Control V, 490. Okay, and again getting the second value, horizontal value, which is 42.375. That's it. 42.375. That's it. Okay. Okay. And let's configure the third one. The position 42.375, and we have to get the end value. Before that, we are only configuring the horizontal moment. So I'm unchecking the vertical. The moment is starting from 50 to 75. And the start value, I'm getting this value 490, and for getting the end value, I have to configure the next one. Okay. And okay. So the third one, here you can get the third one. And the position, we check fix MVF. Okay. The input value should be 75 to 100. We are getting the absolute at the start point 148.125. I'm going to copy this. Okay. I'm going to paste on this horizontal moment. Horizontal endpoint will be 148. That's it. And okay. And this one should be position. This one should be moving horizontal and vertical combined. So I'm checking the vertical also. Getting the runtime values 148, 43 point and the end value. So I should get the end values also. So click OK. Okay. I'm going to get the horizontal and vertical end values of the last one. Position, and I'm checking the horizontal and vertical positions. So getting the start values 61.12 and 193.87. 61.12 for the first one. 61.12 for the first one. And also we have to check for the second one. So go to the position for second one. So the start get values for the vertical 193.87. Answer. This is my vertical value. That's it. And okay. So let's make a trial run. Go to the runtime from here. Here you can see this is my runtime, and I didn't give it the slider value. So go to double click here. Okay, and go to the tools. Data entry expert. By selecting this, go to the data entry expert. You can see that new slider entry and fetch limits at runtime write continuously. These are my tags, and okay, go to the runtime. Then here you can see four things are the moment is correct. The first one is moving up to 25, and the second one is moving up to after 25. And the third one is moving after 75, and the fourth one, and we have successfully given the four movements for the four blocks, but we have to move it one by one, and we have to set the visibility. So getting the visibility, double click, go to the advanced, go to visibility, you can see true, and the tag, I have to assign my tag MVF. Okay, and have to delete these rows, and my low limit range comparison, and have to get the range comparison and the use current output and low, and my low values for the moment or the visibility is zero, and the high value should be 25. That's it, 0 to 25, and the string will be true. Up to that point, the first block will be true. That's it. Okay. And setting the visibility for the second one. Go to advanced configuration. Go to visibility. True. And tag name should be fix mvf.cv. Okay. And delete these rows. Use current output. Delete these other rows. The only one. The low value should be at 25, and the high value should be at 50. Up to until that time, that should be visible. So true. And okay. Okay, and the third one as well, configure visibility through tag name fix mv f. Okay, table, sorry, table user table current value, delete all these other values. The low range is starting from 50 to the high range up to 75, that should be visible. Okay, the string should be true. Okay, and okay, and this should be visible at true fix mv f. Okay, and visibility, I'm going to delete these rows, use current output, delete the rows, and the low value should be at 75, starting from 75, ending at 100. Okay, that's it. True and okay. So we have configured our visibility also. So let's go to the runtime. On the runtime, all these three blocks are invisible. So I'm going to make it run. So increasing my values, you can see that the movement is happening to horizontal, and the first block should be invisible at 25. See, it is the second block and it is moving upwards, up and moving with vertical and horizontal combined motion, and now it is, the second block is also invisible, and the third block is visible. Now it is moving towards left side horizontally, and the combined motion of horizontal and vertical towards the top. This is my vertical movement. That's it. So hope you understand my video. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share and subscribe my video.